At around 4:30 a.m. Central Standard Time, our satellites detected a storm approaching the Ares III mission site on Mars. At 6:45, the storm had escalated to severe, and we had no choice but to abort the mission. Thanks to the quick action of Commander Lewis, astronauts Beck, Johansson, Martinez, and Vogel were all able to reach the Mars ascent vehicle and perform an emergency launch at 7:28 Central Time. Unfortunately, during the evacuation, astronaut Mark Watney was struck by debris and killed.
Stability warning. Oxygen level critical.
No. This is Mark Watney, astronaut. I'm entering this log for the record, in case I don't make it. It is 06:53 on Sol 19, and I'm alive, obviously, but I'm guessing that's gonna come as a surprise to my crewmates and to NASA. And to the entire world, really, so. Surprise!
I gotta figure out a way to grow 3 years' worth of food here. On a planet where nothing grows. Luckily, I'm the botanist. They say that once you grow crops somewhere, you've officially colonized it. So, technically, I colonized Mars.
Look, I mean, I don't mean to sound arrogant or anything, but I am the greatest botanist on this planet. So,
in your face, Neil Armstrong.
So since you're blowing off steam, might as well see how many shots you can make. Might as well make it fun.
Oh, that's awesome. You're going to be eating potatoes and only potatoes? Oh. Potatoes, potatoes, potatoes. You're going to be dreaming potatoes, buddy. Great, you get to cook potatoes in the morning for lunch and dinner. You'll be thinking about potatoes even in your sleep. You're gonna become a potato pretty soon.
Salanum tuberosum!
Terrific! That'll give you enough food until the rescue team arrives.
Warning. Half breach. Explosion imminent.
Mark, we see that your crops have been destroyed. That sucks, but that's not the worst of it. You're gonna freeze to death unless we find a way to keep you warm. We'll try to come up with something, bud. Hang in there. Okay, Watney, the good news? We found a way to keep you warm. Here's the bad news. You gotta dig up plutonium, buddy. You're good at that, right? I believe in you. Once you've uncovered it by removing the rocks, you need to place a cylinder in the box and close the lid. But be careful. I don't think I need to tell you what radiation can do to your human body. It's not good. Great job, Mark. I mean, not much for style points, but it's going to keep you warm.
I'm leaving for the Schiaparelli crater right now, and I'm going to commandeer the Ares IV lander. Nobody explicitly gave me permission to do this, and they can't until I'm on board the Ares IV. So, I'm going to be taking control of a craft in international waters without permission, which by definition makes me a pirate. Mark Watney, space pirate.
Buddy, but there's one more thing you gotta do before you leave. You have to place two more solar panels on the back of the rover. Use the controllers to operate the crane. Lift the panels onto the back of the rover, but be careful because if one breaks, you won't have enough energy to make it back to the Schiaparelli crater and the Ares IV lander.
Storm approaching. T-minus 1 minute.
Think of it like a video.
Storm location, east.
They're doing good.
Please visually verify. Dude, hurry up.
Great job, buddy. Great job. All right, sign that up.
Okay. Let's do this.
All right, there's some larger rocks ahead of you. Yeah, don't crash into them. Steer around them. Okay, grab the joystick.
First I was afraid. I was petrified.
Great job, buddy. I know you're probably not comfortable with this terrain, you being a botanist and everything, but good job. Okay, we're almost there, buddy. Almost there. Well done. Okay, once you get on board, you're gonna have to make the ship lighter, but I'll explain once you get inside.
Power failure. Start power up sequence.
Okay, Mark, listen, you're going to have to press the green button in front of you to blow the hatches. The green one. Make sure green. This will help you make the ship lighter and get you to target altitude. Can you stay away from that button?
Power failure. Searching for problem. Check breaker 1924.
All right, good. Yeah, we're still too heavy though. Push the yellow button to eject the nose cone, see what that does. Look up and behind you. Make sure that the nose cone is released. Great, just toss out the other acceleration seats and get strapped in. You're good to go.
Mission Control, we are a go for launch and will proceed on schedule.
T-minus 10.
9.
Main engine start.
8. 7. About 5 seconds, Watney. Hang on. 4.
See you in a few, Commander.
3. 2. 1.
Okay, Watney, release your safety harness, look up, and make your way through the nose cone. There you go.
Distance to intercept will be 68 kilometers apart.
68 kilometers? Did you just say 68 kilometers?
Okay, you're not gonna like this, Mark. But you need to puncture your glove and use the escaping air to steer yourself towards the Hermes.
I gotcha.
Oh, awesome!
You're coming home.
Welcome back, Watney. It's good to have you back, bud.
Every human being has a basic instinct to help each other out. If a hiker gets lost in the mountains, people coordinate a search. If a train crashes, people will line up to give blood. If an earthquake levels the city, people all over the world send emergency supplies. This instinct is found in every culture without exception. And because of it, I had an entire planet on my side. Which means I still have several billion people left to thank. That's okay, though. I have nothing but time. For now, I'm just gonna enjoy the moment.